This is, doesn't take very long to come to a conclusion that what we are searching for is in a limited area. And if we want to narrow that down further, where am I thinking from? Not operating outside in the world. Where am I operating inside myself? Where are my thoughts coming? To see that, we look at the thoughts. Something we mostly have never been taught how to do. We have never been taught, we have been taught how to look at pictures outside, books outside, scenes outside, people outside. Never taught how to look at our own thoughts inside. But we can look at them. How? By putting our attention on the thoughts. Because when we look outside, we also look by putting attention outside. So if we have to look inside, we should also look with the same power of attention. So in order to look inside our own head, our physical head, where thoughts are taking place, simple way would be close your eyes so that you don't see outside. Don't get distracted. Close your eyes and see your thoughts. Now thoughts are in two forms. They speak language, words, the language we have been taught. And many of our thoughts are taking place in that same language, which we learned. So long as the thoughts are speaking in us, and I want to tell you good news, they're always speaking. So you don't have to wait for them to speak. Thoughts speak continuously, without fail. If they stop speaking, we will die. That is why, just like this, a heart must beat all the time. If the heart stops, we die. If thoughts stop speaking, that means they stop thinking, we die. Therefore, they are always thinking 24/7. So no problem in listening to them. The second form the thoughts take is visualization. Make pictures. And thoughts come and we imagine things and we can see them. Very often, the two are connected. Sometimes they are not connected. But most of the time, when we think of something in words, we make pictures similar to what we are thinking. So we can watch our thoughts two ways. We can watch our thoughts by listening to them, and we can watch our thoughts by looking at what they are imagining. That's a beautiful experience if you try it. If you try to be one who is going to watch the thoughts and one who is going to see the thoughts in pictures, obviously, you will realize you are neither the thoughts nor the picture you are seeing. You are the one looking at them. This exercise is so vital and important because that's the first time you will realize you are neither thoughts nor the images that you see. Otherwise, we are always thinking we are thoughts. That we are, the self is speaking in the thought. If you could separate yourself to see who's speaking, you will see the mind that thinks and speaks is not yourself. That you are separate from the mind. That's a great experience because otherwise we never differentiate between ourselves and our thoughts. And we get so immersed in the thoughts. I am thinking, I am thinking. We always say, I am thinking. Nobody ever says, I am aware of my mind that I make it think in this way. I am using my mind to think, which is the truth. The truth is, I can never think. The self can never think. Self does not need to think. Self is pure consciousness. It is the ability to be aware. It can be aware that it can create a mind that can think and use it, which we are doing very well. In fact, we are overdoing it. We are overdoing the use of the mind and not doing it the way it was designed to be used.